13.02, so if he keeps that going, he's going to be way inside his personal best. Tom Matko, it's his first
time. Well everyone!
Alex Stewart.
Yeah. Matt Belshaw is just from over the lap time. Can you give us a wave, Matt Belshaw? And there it goes. More than just an athlete. He's on his way. He's done his first lap and a quarter from the Forrester team. Wayne Stewart is racing and from the flying.
Should have brought your
wave for him. Andy Reid is from Team Bath AC and Dursley Running Club. Neil Malpass, Roller Neil, we hope you enjoy the race. The two athletes are checking in at the moment, so we are racing in the 9-bar Chile Duathlon.
Well done, Johnny!
You can go and register now.
Hello, Johnny.
Good stuff, Johnny, welcome!
Get yourself wrapped, and then you're all ready. We will be starting the first wave at 11:30 a.m. Jennifer O'Connor from Avon Valley Runners. Good morning, Jennifer. There's lots of Avon Valley Runners here today from Cirencester AC. Happy birthday, Joyce Matthews. Joyce, have you got cake for us all at the finish? Yes, she has. Joyce, happy 41st birthday. What a great way to spend your day with a few hundred friends running around Castle Creek Race Circuit. Steve Bowen here at Steak Restaurant. So he said this proves that red meat works. Mike Nichols, he's gradually returned his competitive running after a break of about 2 years. He's racing in our Supervec 60
category. Doing a duathlon. Oh, well, that's the Phil's going to give it a go as well.
How's your recovery coming on? We hope it's going well.
He's done many before.
John Lawson, he's on his way to Edward Kerr, hoping to beat 51 and 52 minutes, which were his previous races. Edward Kerr is also his
turn. Hello, James, well done, Dean. What a mark.
Just a lap time of 15 minutes and 1 second. But Sarah Cockett, her first ever race since the Bournemouth Marathon. Lona Joyce, we hope you're happy with running from Summer AC. Denise Osborne, Julian Gardner, racing running for Arthritis Research UK. And it's the final event in his 10x10k challenge. Richard Dalton on his way. Julian Hinton, well, that's you. Julian is running. Catherine Roberts is going well. She's to be much faster. Well, that happens to us all, but she's still running. Rose Batali said she used to be quite slow, but she's just old.
Well, Nathan.
She used to be fast, but now old and slow, but it doesn't look like that to me. Anthony Greenswein is on his way. Caroline O'Brien, Samantha White, hope you're racing well, just in lap time of just only 16 minutes. Claire Wallace has been injured, so she's hoping to complete today. Bristol Tech Cave and Joe Solding. Well done, Claire, we hope you had a great day today.
Well done, Sarah!
Wales is Melon Cancer Support T-shirt with pride. Well done, Kevin Church, give us a wave as you go past.
Go get the bike for
it. We hope you're enjoying it. Claire John, it's only her second ever 10K. She's hoping to beat 58.08. She's just done her first full lap in just under 16 seconds. So she is way inside. Will Wiltshire is on the way. Philip Harrison is on the way. Louise Chamberlain is running, so is Philip Harrison. Nigel Chamberlain is running as well.
Guys, keep going,
Mitchell, you're a team to me.
Her second ever 10K, Kirsty Constable is on her way, as is Magdalena Kreft. She's running well. Emma Townsend is still racing. Margaret Dunby's just up her lap in just under 17 minutes. Ian Jordan in his comeback run, he's just lapped in 17 minutes. Catherine Fennell is a new runner. Where's Catherine? Well done, Catherine. This is her, we think, her second 10K. Julie Bright is racing. Sandra Brindley is on her way. Stina Watkins is racing. E5I on the way. Julie Wood, only her third ever 10K. She's been racing for 4 months. Rachel Boatman, she's running in the London Marathon for a matchup. We've had Dursley, and great to be your Dursley teammate. Damien Lai started running in January as part of the Look to Run program, so we hope you're doing well. Matthew Shepherd, first of every event, congratulations. Michael Middleton, welcome to you. Laura Creese, another first time racer here today. Jonathan Pendery running with Brother Mark, hoping for a PB. And Richard Collins has just lapped in 17 and a half minutes. Ian Collins, been running for 2 months. Sarah Bella is on her way as well.
Okay, I'll just go grab that camera and bring it inside.
Athletes coming through having completed their second lap. Most of them have been lapping in under 11 and a half minutes. So Simon Morgan's on his, just going to, he's on his way to complete his third lap and the finish. Amanda Bell is on her first ever 10K. Jeremy Freeling's just done his second lap in under 12 minutes. Stephen Edge tells us he's from the north, but he's raced just on his second lap in 11:34. Russell Langley, second time running this event, second lap in. Russell Langley, yes, second lap 11:37, first lap 11:44. Consistent running from him. Ruth Matthews is running today. She's just done her first lap in 19:25. Give us a wave, Ruth Matthews. Tells us it's her first event since having her daughter Lucy last year. Ruth, welcome back to running. Darren Legg's just done his second lap in 11:52. And Drew Cunliffe has just lapped in 11:43. Victoria Lowe, just on her first lap in 20 minutes and 12 seconds.
Well done, guys.
Big deal, I'm at the 9K point now.
Sweet, happy days, thank you. Guy at the finish, you receive him.
Yeah, you probably got about 3 minutes till the first finisher.
Francis Evers is on the way. Joanne Gibbard and the North Bristol running group is still going. Julio Pantardi has just done a second lap in 12 minutes and 12. First one was 12:23. Well done, Julius. I just saw two people running past in very large backpacks. Not quite sure of the date, but well done to you. It's relatively hard than it would have been.
No, it's
this is her first 10K back after having her third baby in March. Hercules did his first lap in 12:30 and his second in 12:28.
Mike, you're about 2.5 minutes away from first finisher. It's the runner, as far as I'm aware. That's the runner. The wheel chair looks like
it's open lane as well.
Yes.
Is this the finish line?
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, yeah. So you can see Nathan Brackley, our wheelchair competitor, looks like he's
on the other side.
What, so they'll run to
just
left?
Just about
yeah.
to come
Thanks.
Off it's all right.
the... Just about to come around. And I think we are just 1 or 2 minutes away from our final, our first finisher, as the first runner finisher as well. There goes Nathan Blackie. He's under the Avon Bridge and he's on his way to the finish. He races for Paul AC. And in a moment we're going to get the readout of Nathan Blackie's time as he comes over. He's our first finisher today at the Night Bar Chile event, organised by DB Max. Jeremy Moore. First ever row in the Chile 10K. He's just done his second lap at 12:58.
Well done, Lou. Well done. Keep going, mate.
Take
the water
on if you need it.
Yeah,
Lucky.
It was Daddy.
Go on, Tony.
Looking good.
He's down there.
And it looks like we Nathan Blackie, we're just waiting for final finish time. We're finishing in about 32 minutes. So our first run is just about to come under the arch. This is David Bell from Cirencester AC. Current race time is about 32:45, so he's going to be coming in just under 33 minutes, I would expect. First full lap was 9:44, second full lap 9:46, as we can see the second runner on their way to come under the Avon Bridge. And there's David Bellas over the line in a time of 32:52. Well done, David Bell. Our winner today from Cirencester AC, the winner of today's Night Bar Chile 10K. Jake Smith, who's done lots of 10K races in the past, he's hoping to run a sub 34 minutes 10K. He has easily come in inside of that. What a time of 33:21. Jake Smith, you have achieved your aim. 33:21. He wanted some 34 minutes. He got himself a second place. He's on the podium and a PB to boot. Chris Davis is on his way round. He's got one more race to go. Matthew Powell, first ever event. One more lap to go. Angus Boyd, first invented in many years from Leichhardt Manistrides from the Flying Monk Triathlon Club. Excited Love is on his way. Lap times of 14:57, 14:42. Tim Slater tells us again to wish his mom Julian a happy birthday.
I'll keep doing
the is too early to get to the finish. By the time they get to the finish, they've put a huge amount of distance between themselves and the third place runner, who will pick up as they come out. Tom Crockford's got one more lap to go. Yes, away. Did you go past Tom?
Come down and give me a hand.
Yep, he says maybe. Mark Parkhurst. His PB is 50 minutes and 12 seconds. He's on track for a PB. Mark Parkhurst is on track for a great PB for the Boston Dean Athletics Club. Graham Bonito is on his way. Our third place athlete is just coming under the bridge. Our third place athlete is Chris Lucas. He's also got Terry Jervis and Mike Rose with him. So we're going to see who's going to make it over the line. There we go. Mike Rose is over the line in the time of 35.24 to claim the final podium slot. So our top three in the names, 9-bar Chili 10K of Jake Smith in the time of 33.21. In second place, Chris Lucas with 35.14 and only 10 seconds behind. In third place is Mike Rose. Well done to the first three finishers. Congratulations, they're going to be at the finish line getting their goodies and their medal right now. As we go back to out on the track, Kirsty Brummage has been running for 18 months. Lucky to get to London Marathon for next year. And looking forward to racing that. Sophie Barrister racing, Chris Harrison's racing, and so is Mark Morgan from the London City Running Club. He's just lapped in 15.07, first lap 15.01, very consistent. Edward Kerr, his third DB Max event, his PB is 52 minutes. Richard Dayton, 23 years with no exercise, did he catch the 10K program? And here he is, he's only got one more lap left. Very decent time, looking like he's going to post today. Darren O'Connor. He's on his way. Her first race six, the Bournemouth Marathon. It's Sarah Cockin. David Webb, he's 62 and it'll be his fifth 10K. He's been jogging since the age of 18 when he wasn't a fast breaker. Esther Gardner wants to go under 50 minutes. She's almost on track. Esther, I think you're going to need to put a bit more speed on. You're going to be very close to your sub 50, but Esther, where are you? Give us a wave. Keep running, Esther. No time to wave. There you go. I need you to be very close to your 50 minutes.
Thank you, big need you upstairs straight away.
Lindsay Park. Lindsay Park. She's on her way. First lap in 15.12, second lap in 15.49. Charlie Beecham, he's still racing. He's got one more lap left to go. And Martha Wheeler tells us she has an unhealthy obsession with cleaning. Well, Martha, if that's what you're telling us, I won't show you my car that I brought here today. The inside is a disgrace. Julian Gardner, raising money for Arthritis Research UK. And Paul Gillow, well done to you, Paul Gillow. Michael Day, he's still racing, and Laura McMayes.
Keep going.
All right, I'm on the way to the spot. If anyone can get there before me, we've lost connection on that. So there you go, mate. If anyone can get to the spot on that before me, I'm on
So we're going to be doing our presentation for the 10K. Our presentation of awards will be at 20 past 11.
All good, guys.
I can't say no to jelly babies.
Can you?
So down at the finish line to see the athletes coming through. Don't forget our top three for today in the 9-bar chili 10K is David Bell in 32.52 G, Smith in 33. Chris Lucas in 35.14.
Did I see you? Christian Kim is good, Orange is not actually connected. No, I'm on the other side of the track here. Oh, I'm on the way back up.
Clearly the bigger champions, David Bell, 32.52.
You were neck and neck
with your second place with Jake Smith right when you were going through the track. And then you were still close on the second time. When did you start to pull away?
I'm really impressed. The first couple of laps, you really gave me run for my money. And I think it's about 6K, it was a very slight rise. And I thought, I'm pretty good, I just tested a little bit. And just managed to pull away slightly from it. But fantastic, really impressive.
You talk about the slight rise. Most people think race circuits are flat. And I'm sure if you're driving around here at 160 miles an hour, it seems flat. Are those sort of the very cheap, gradual lanes that you wouldn't notice, do you think?
Yeah, I probably wouldn't call it a step up in the pavement, you know, that's going to affect the time, that's going to be a hill, but when you're running around, you're really going to be a wind factor. Are you used to running on the track, or is it mostly hilly stuff?
I kind of travel a little bit where I live, so I've got the time for the day, it's quite hilly around there, so it's quite good training, I do get quite happy to come here, there was a lot less muddy kit to wear at the time to be washing after today, and I see you've got, I'm assuming this is your daughter here, who's enjoying her post-race chocolate with her 9-bar chili 10k medal as well. Does she come support you at most of the races?
Yes, she does. So I just want to say a big thank you to my wife here, Sophie, with my two daughters, my partner, and I love you guys, really appreciate it coming up on a cold day like this. So let me just ask you about that.
I mean, obviously you were racing significantly faster than everyone else today. How much difference does it make? If someone's never done a race before and they're supporting, tell me what speed you are, just having, you know, what you've done and the fight, so what I might do is just grab that badge inside, that's it, I'll see you on the other side, okay, quite, okay.
And then just how it's really going round, just knowing that there are people watching you, and yeah, makes you push on a bit harder, particularly when you know they've come out in the cold, you don't want to be out for too long. And the same for everybody else that supports these events, just having people around the track really makes it difficult. So.
Yeah, you can't underestimate it. Don't do that. Wish you well. Thank you very much. Congratulations again. 32.52. You're not going to be able to stay around for the prize giving. I'm going to see if I can sneak in and pretend to be David Bell, but I don't think there's much chance. Congratulations. We'll see you back again next year.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, everyone.
Well, great effort. All right.
Could the athletes numbers 1229 and 987 please go into transition to see the referee? You're just in the wrong place. Thank you.
Hey, Vicky.
from the results for the running's race in the 9-mile Chile 10K. First place, Elizabeth Smith, time of 30.34. Anna Weller in 42.14 was in second place. And Laura Baker in 43.27. So if Elizabeth Smith is still around, could you come to the DB Max? DB Max. Right, we have an athlete who's just finished. Will Whitmer. Is it easier to organise and host a race than it is to run it? Or is it much harder work actually organising a race?
These days, I think it's much harder running it.
What was your time in the end? I haven't seen it come up yet.
I think I sneaked under 49 minutes. By my record in that, it's £108 for charity.
Excellent. Have you decided the charity yet?
We drew out a hat the other day, and it was the NICU in Bath, which helped out one of the children of one of our runners. So that's why she nominated it, and that's the one that we drew out the hat.
Okay, perfect. Listen, well, congratulations. Don't forget, like everyone else, you can get your printout of your timing in the Strawford Centre. You probably know all this already, but every athlete can get their printout in the Strawford Centre. They can see their race time. And it'll be online, well, it's probably already online now, isn't it?
Yeah, they're live uploaded as we run around the track. So I'm not sure I want to see my splits, but I might go and have it.
It's great to see you well running, and we'll see you out on the track working in a minute. Thanks a lot. Cheers.
Well done, folks. Keep going.
Just a reminder that our awards and presentations for the 9-bar Chile 10K will be at 11:20. We've still got athletes coming over the finish.
You need to go back down to the bottom and drop out again. Okay, mate, I'm just opening race check on the jersey.
Finish for you. Calling in the finishers, Kerry Sutton, Jeremy Moore, Catherine Green, Russell Langley, Daryl Phillips, Jack Gober, they are all over the line. Andy Conning and Louis Gillow is as well. Still out on the course, she's on her final lap. Elsa Littlewood, give us a wave, Elsa, as you go past. It's her first ever 10K. Is it your first ever 10K, Elsa? Yes, it is. She said she was inspired by runners in her home village of Hawkesbury Upton. Well done to you, Elsa. We will see you when you finish your final lap. Jill Weeks is on her final lap. She has done races up for her. 2013. Jean Gibbs has been running for over 30 years at every race, despite the effort. She said it is becoming a personal worst, but Jean, we don't care if we don't care. She's running in the Superbike 60 category, and there she goes. She's on the final lap. Victoria Goddard in her second ever 10K. She's still on her way. Elaine Greenstreet, give us a wave as well. Is that Elaine and Victoria running together, it looks like? There we go. Their first laps were about 21, 22 minutes, and second lap's pretty much the same, so they're running consistently. Are you going to keep running the whole way, ladies? Yes, they are. We will see them both at the finish. Victoria Goddard is also on her way as well. So just a reminder, our 10K presentation and awards will be at 11:25. 11:25 will be our 9-bar chili 10K registration, presentation and awards. So if you've just arrived today, welcome to the 9-bar chili duathlon. It is going to be held today at the Castle King Race Circuit. Organised by DV Max Events, this is our 10th running of these events. We have the 9-bar chili 10K that is still underway. We have athletes still running. And then we have the 9-bar chili duathlon. Our first wave for that is starting at 11:30 is the first wave, 11:30, and our second wave is at 10 past 12. Just over the lap for her last lap. Janice Stockham there.
What time are you back?
PB is an hour and 18. At the moment, Janice, I think you're on for a PB, so keep it going. Are you going to run the whole way, Janice? Yes, she is. And there goes Cindy Lydell as well. Two arms in the air. She's got plenty of energy left. She's still running. And there she goes. She's just got one lap to go. In addition to Nine Bar, our title sponsor, who will be giving out the goodies at the finish, and are also giving out goodies to some of the spectators as well, we have team coffee available from the Runcible Spoon Caterpod, just down by the transition area. And the Tavern Restaurant is open. The Tavern Restaurant is open for breakfast right up until midday. Bacon and sausage rolls available. We'd also like to thank our on-site sports massage team from the Physio Clinic in Bristol. Just before we do that, we'd like to say a big hello to James Roberts and I think that's Victoria Aubrey Reese. Did I get that right? Yes. So I think that is a husband and wife team. New wife. James has said he's supporting his new wife. Said she wasn't looking forward to the race, but she is looking forward to a nice medal. Is that correct? There we go. Right. First lap about 23 minutes. Second lap about 25. So keep it consistent. James and Victoria, enjoy your day. Michelle Knight, give us a wave, Michelle Knight. There she goes. One more lap to go. It's her second 10K in the last 6 months. She only started running properly in May when she did the Greater Manchester Marathon. So for those of you racing in the 9 bar chili duathlon,
has he on it?
Don't forget that your registration is open. The registration for the duathlon closes in 15 minutes. So if you have just arrived here to the Castle King Racing, welcome to the 10th 9 bar chili duathlon. We'd like to welcome each and every one of you, whether you are racing or spectating. Time is now 11 o'clock. Registration for the duathlon closes in 15 minutes. So once you've arrived, you can go straight to registration, get your race numbers and your bike stickers, put those on your bike and your helmet, and then in you go to transition. Get yourself into transition as soon as you can, and then you'll be ready. The briefing for the first wave will be at 11:20 in front of the Strawford Centre. So we will be calling you for that in just over 10 minutes. So if you're racing in wave one briefing, you need to be ready in just over 10 minutes. Wave one duathletes, you have just over 10 minutes. So don't forget this afternoon, in addition to the 9 bar chili duathlon that's being held today, we also have the BUCS, that's the British Universities and Colleges Sports Duathlon Championships 2015. We've got our connection back to the finish line, so I'd like to welcome in the finishers, Kerry Sutton, Jeremy Moore, Catherine Green, Russell Langley.
How many have we got left there?
Think this through.
On their way in to finish, Lauren Webb, Sophie Niblett, Alex Stokes, Natalie Downing, Libby Jackson, Sarah Eden, Mark Power, Tim Davis, Deb Veer, Tanya Thomas, it's her first ever event. Deb Veer is running with a friend, it's her first ever 10K as well. Lauren Webb was hoping for a PB. Not sure what your PB was, Lauren, but we hope you got it anyway. So just putting your crown out. Just checking, Sally. If you're near the finish line and you can hear this, would you just wave? If you're at the finish line, could you just wave if you can hear this, or just after the finish line? Yeah. Georgina Wilde said she needed motivation to get moving, but she looked like she was moving pretty well today. Jeff Kirk, on his way to the finish, just said he was glad to be out and running. Jane Morgan is about to be a finisher. Stella Jensen, running one 10K race every month for a year. Christine James is about to get a medal around her neck. And in her first ever 10K, Elizabeth Walker is coming in to finish. Amy Fannin, Craig Sanderson, Tom Oland, and Andrew Wyatt Sugg are all finishers. Mark Gallagher started running in June. Lindsay Parks are finishing. Katie Marshall, David Rogers, Sean Bignell, and Nikki Allway. Nikki, this is her third ever 10K, hoping to beat her 1 hour 6 minute PB. And Nikki, it looks like you've done that, or you've almost done it. Louise Blakeway started 2015 with the Chile 10K race in February, and here she is ending her season. Heidi Hind, it's her first ever 10K since she started running just 2 months ago. Nicholas Taylor had never run before his Couch to 5K session in April. Well done to you. Tracy Goodall, first ever running event. Jonathan Williams, he's about to be a finisher as well and get his finish line goodies. Liz Sweet, well done at your race. We hope you enjoyed it. Joanne Hewitt, she's about to come over the line. Fiona Brooks, Tammy Zalek,
is that the last,
Victoria
last
Taylor.
Done, yeah?
Do you want to break her ankle?
Can you be
100%
certain?
Looks like she's
back. No, I haven't. No, so I haven't.
Adrian Turner. It's his first ever 10K. He's never run this far before. Well done, Adrian. Your work here is done. Don't forget to all of our finishers, once you've got your goodies at the finish line, you can get food and drink from the tavern restaurants. Their all-day breakfasts are going all the way up to 12 o'clock, and then they've got lunch. The Runcible Spoon Cater Pod is down by the transition area, and they are selling teas and coffees and some snacks. Mark Stevens is running today to fundraise for leukemia and lymphoma research. Well done to you, Mark. Hope you enjoyed yourself. So for everyone racing in the duathlon, you need to get into registration very quickly. Registration is going to end for the duathlon in just under 10 minutes. If you are racing in wave one in the duathlon, your race briefing is going to be starting in just under 10 minutes. Wave one. Wave one briefing will be in just over 10 minutes. Wave one briefing. Don't forget, you have had race photos. If you have already raced today, your race photos from Charles Watson Photography will be online. We're in a couple of days at charleswattonphotography.com. Just a reminder, the nine bar team are here. They're not only giving out their glorious, very nice natural energy bars, the seed energy bars. They're not only giving those out to athletes, but also some of the spectators. And they're handing those out. They're walking around giving those out now. Don't forget, you can also get your time from downstairs at the Strawford Centre, where you can see your time in the race. Thank you.